What I'd like to first of all do, if that's okay with the rest of the committee, is there was comments made regarding different plans, and I was of the understanding that plans have already been looked at, so I'd like my future comments on that committee first.
Thank you, through you, Chair. This proposal was subject to detailed pre-application discussions with the applicant. And to pick up on the comments that Councillor Elderton has made and the ward councillor, we did have discussions with the applicant earlier than this application about a large square building in this portion of the site, which we felt wasn't appropriate, that it went against the principles of the conservation area and indeed would be more intrusive in the street scene. And so the applicants did go away and have now come up with two smaller linear proposals in this court-shaped proposal. So I think it would be wrong for members to go away with the impression that an alternative scheme hasn't already been looked at, because we did do that at an earlier stage, but for various reasons that I won't trouble the committee with, and that proposal was in back.
Thanks,
Matthew.
I've had an indication from Phil that you'd like to speak based on what Steve has commented on. Would you like Councillor Alison to refusal first, or would you like to speak first? So, do you want to listen to the reasons for refusal, or would you like to speak first?
That course just goes in first.
Once we've got the move refusal, then it goes to a vote.
I'm actually, I have a great sympathy for conservation areas, and I'm just not convinced, as of the last application, that this is actually a detriment to the conservation area. I'm not particularly certain it enhances it, but I think it very least it maintains what was there before, especially considering the tree preservation orders around the borders and stuff. And it's also good to see that the road is being widened, as I suspect it is quite dangerous. That's it.
Would you like to give us your comments for?
Yeah, thank you very much. And thanks for your input to that. I understand where you're coming from. I've given this a lot of consideration, so I won't beat about the bush and just say my view is that the proposed development, by virtue of the number of dwellings proposed and their siting, and having regards to important landscape features and trees to be retained, represents an overdevelopment of the site which would be out of keeping and be detrimental to the character and appearance of the area. The proposed development is therefore contrary to policies HS4, HS5 and CH11 of the Wirral Unitary Development Plan, the CALDY Conservation Area Character Appraisal and the Management Plan and the National Planning Policy Framework. So move that, Chair.
Okay, so Councillor Alderson has moved refusal. All those in favour? All those in favour of refusal? Against? That's all. Thank you.
planning permission is sought for the subdivision of this property into two dwellings. The existing property is a large detached dwelling located on a corner plot. The property has consent for the conversion into three self-contained flats, which has been partially completed, but this application seeks consent for two dwellings, resulting in effect for the pair of semi-detached dwellings. But just so that members can understand, this is the existing house here, and essentially just across the back of the site, the house will be subdivided. So this will be one house, and this will be the second house. An earlier application also sought permission for an additional three dwellings in the garden to the rear, so three dwellings here. But due to concerns about overdevelopment, that application was subsequently withdrawn. This current proposal would result in one fewer unit than the three already consented and partially implemented, and therefore it's considered the reduction of units on the site will be an improvement. Sufficient private community space is retained for both units, and there will be no overlooking or loss of privacy as existing openings are utilised and standard separation distances are achieved. Off-street parking provision is provided for both units, and again the reduction of units from the previously approved three to now proposed two will result in fewer vehicles and vehicular movements at the site. A front balcony is proposed for the main dwelling, and so it's roughly in this location here. Balconies are not uncommon features given the views from the front of properties along Mell's Drive, Mell's Parade, and towards the sea. The property next door, number 66, so that's this property here, also has a similar balcony. Overlooking the potential loss of privacy would not be an issue as the council separation distances are all comfortably achieved. The proposal is considered to comply with policy HS4, which allows new residential development within the primary residential area, and as such, the application is recommended for approval. There's a petition in regards to this application.
Thank you, Matthew. Is the board council that
Thank you, Chairman. I live less than half a mile from this particular property, and it had been derelict for very many years, and it's really recently had some work done on it, which has improved it considerably, because it did look a bit of an eyesore. So I think this is a very good and worthwhile development, and it will definitely enhance the area, and I cannot see any valid reasons for turning it down, so I will certainly be supporting the officer's recommendations to approve this application.
Thanks.
Thank you, Chair. In the representations, it was said about no building control involved in the build, and also, is it a retrospective plans? Have they actually started this planning application? Because that's what it's saying here, isn't it? In the representations.
Sorry, just to confirm, the site has got a consent for three flats, and that scheme has been partially implemented. This scheme hasn't been implemented, and as you know, building control is a separate process to planning.
Anybody else? Okay.
Move the recommendation, Chair.
Sorry?
I move the recommendation.
Okay, thank you. Do you have a seconder? Thank you, Catherine. All those in favour of approval suggest the conditions listed. That's unanimous. We can move to agenda item 7, which is pages 45 and 52.
Thank you, Chair. Planning permission is sought for the construction of. The construction of two self-contained four-bedroom units within the grounds of an existing care facility. So just so that members can understand, this is Arrow 4 here, where the daycare centre is written. And then the proposed units, there's one here and one here, so in an L shape. Arrow 4 is used in connection with assisted living facilities for adults with autism, learning difficulties and associated needs. The proposed proposal seeks consent to erect two units in the grounds of Arrow Hall adjacent to the main buildings, which will provide a staged approach to independent living, allowing residents to feel more independent and adjust to independent living before being located more permanently within assisted living sites within the wider community. These units will provide short-term accommodation whilst allowing the wider support facilities at Arrow Hall to be accessed. Policy SH7 permits sheltered housing provided it relates well to surrounding property. Although located within the green belt, the units are single-storey and timber construction and sited at the rear of our hall on the existing area of power standing, therefore minimising any impact on the open green belt. The proposals are considered to be acceptable and in accordance with unit tree development plan policies. There have been no objections to this proposal and there is no petition submitted in connection with the application, which is
Thank you, Matthew. Is
there a
board council like to
I'm just saying, I don't think I'm going to be able to see that.
Any comments from anybody else? Are you approved? Okay, thank you. All those in favour of approval, subject to the condition listed? That's unanimous. Harry, thank you. Agenda items 8, 9 and 10 are subject to the site visit, so we'll to agenda item 11, which is pages 73 to 78 of the current presentation paper.
Thank you, through you, Chair. This application seeks permission for the change of use of land to a private garden in association with Wellington Barn. Wellington Barn is this property here. This property here is Mill Farm. It's in association with the one on top of Wellington Farm. The land is greenbelt and lies directly north and east of Wellington Farm, which was a full agricultural building that has been converted into a dwelling. The application is retrospective, with the area currently being used as private garden space in connection with Wellington Farm. The retrospective nature of the work forms the basis of objection by the campaign for protection of law in England. Whilst retrospective applications can be frustrating, it is not an offence to carry out work without first obtaining the planning permission, and the absence of planning permission or the retrospective nature of an application is not in itself a reason to refuse an application. However, there is a history with this site because the site has been used as a garden for the past 14 years. So since the barn was originally permitted, it has had limited extensions which have resulted in a four-bedroom family home. The area of land which is the subject of this application is located immediately adjacent to the converted barn and is bounded by mature hedgerows. The area has been fenced off and used as a garden, as I said, for the past 14 years. Evidence has been submitted to the council to demonstrate this has been the case since as early as 2000. Therefore, the applicants could submit a certificate of law for development, which only needs to demonstrate 10 years of use, and the use would be lawful. Such an application could not be conditioned, and the council would have no control over structures that could be erected utilising the development plans. So this retrospective application allows the council to grant permission subject to conditions that prohibit structures being erected, including fences, walls, and without first applying to the council. The change of use and boundary treatment have existed for a significant period of time without any of the properties marked in the green belt. The application is recommended for approval subject to conditions removing the requirement rights, and there is no petition.
Thank you, Matthew. Is there a ward council like to speak on this? Can I open this up to committee?
Can I move approval, Chair?
Thank you. Thank you. All those in favour of approval? That's unanimous. That's carried. Thank you very much. Agenda item 12, subject to assigned figures, and we've already moved 13, so we move to agenda item 14, which is pages 105 to 112.
Thank you, Chair. This application relates to the redevelopment of land Seymour Street and Thompson Street. The proposal seeks permission for the erection of 75 residential units, 55 of which will be houses, 8 will be bungalows and 12 flats. The application area is split into 5 different plots of land covering a total area of 1.58 hectares. The site is designated as primarily residential and forms part of the wider WOODCHURCH Road housing market renewal initiative. The site is bounded by residential gardens with a mix of house types contributing to the area, including terrace properties, semi-detached homes and bungalows. There are also apartments within the wider area. The proposed development, therefore, is in keeping with the predominant land use. Each of the dwellings have off-street parking provision, and the houses all have private amenity space with provision of rear garden areas. The proposed flats and a shed in a landscape garden proposed, and provision of car parking spaces as a ratio of all space per apartment. The mix of house types is in keeping with the wider mix of developments in the area and is not considered to be out of keeping with the character of the area. The proposals also make provision for affordable housing, which will be let on affordable rent tenancy. The affordable housing provision will be secured by a Section 106 agreement. The scale, form, and design of development reflects around developments and is considered to comply with policy HS4 in the Wirral Unitary Development Plan. The proposals are recommended for approval. There is a qualifying petition and objection.
Would the lead petitioner like to come forward to speak on this? The board councillor would like to speak on this? Those of the committee, please.
Move the recommendation.
Thank you. Do we have a seconder? Thank you. All those in favour of approval subject to conditions listed? That's unanimous and carried. Thank you very much. Agenda item 15 on page 193, giving us to note the family commission's decision on the delegated powers between the 12th of June and the 12th of July. Agenda item 16, we ask to note the final appeal decided between the 1st of April and the 30th of June. Are they agreed?
Thank you. Those are mine. Yeah,